Hi guys! Today's lesson is a super important one. Any logo you see out there, famous or not, is most likely created using Boolean operations. Complicated name for a very simple concept, in fact. Boolean operations combine any set of shapes, like these two circles, through one of five formulas: union, subtract, intersect, divide, and exclude, also known as difference. So let's deep dive into each one, one by one, using these shapes here as an example. You can find all the Boolean operations in the Quick Actions menu if you tap this button, and then all five will be listed in this order. But there's also a second way to do this. Going to the Path tab, you'll notice that they're all accessible in here as well at the very top. So let's begin, shall we? I'll select my two circles first, and we'll start off with Unite. Unite is the first function and a very common one as well, and it does what it says in its name. It unites two or more shapes into one. Bear in mind that the shape on top is going to dictate the properties of the resulting object, like the color in my case. And like any vector shape, it can now be edited in any way that you want with the node tool. Move, add, delete nodes, the works. All right, now let's move on to subtract, an operation which removes the area of a shape from a base object. And that is how I created this crescent moon here. As opposed to union, the base shape will maintain its properties after the function is applied. Next up is intersect. If I use this function, I'm going to create a shape from the resulting overlapping areas of two or more objects. And this is how I created this lens-looking silhouette. If we go back, we'll notice that the shape at the bottom will lend its style to the resulting graphic. And that is why it's pink. Going down the list, divide is quite unique in itself and results in the most amount of vector shapes that you can play around with. This operation splits selected objects into individual shapes created by their intersecting paths. It may look like nothing now, but I've actually just created three shapes that I can edit independently. The order of the objects bears no importance here. The last operation was a bit more complex, and the following is no exception. Exclude, or difference, deletes the path that overlaps when two shapes are combined. And the object at the top dictates the style that the final shape takes. Seems a bit conceptual right now, I know, but our next video will put all this theory into practice, so be sure to watch it. I'll see you guys then.